fire fall on me. Like, I'm really fiery red. What's up, good people, aka winners? That's all we do. Ay, that's all we do. Ay. I'm coming to you with another video. Ay, coming to you with another video. Ficky. Ay. I can get your ogre wrong. Ay. Where are my manners? If you have not joined the Winners Fan Bam, now is the time to get on in here, girl and guys, okay? And join the Winners Fan Bam. Let us love on you and give you all these virtual hugs. No, that looked like I love Jeannie. That don't look like a hug, but you get what I'm saying, right? This video is like shout out to everybody trying to get their brows right on quarantine, because I want to make sure that y'all right as well, all right? Because listen, I seen some of my sisters out there like, brows is like, help me. So your sis is here to help you, because listen, when you love somebody, you will tell them the truth. You will not let your friends and family go out there looking cray cray. And so Ciki to the rescue, okay? Let me put on my like Superman cape or something, because, or Wonder Woman maybe, because I'm here to help y'all, because I don't want y'all eyebrows out there looking like a cartoon where you got all these jagged lines. I'm just saying, I just got to keep it real. So I'm going to use a mirror because I don't want to kind of come in like that and then get out of focus. And, but I'm going to help you guys, and hopefully you guys get the gist of it. So I'm going to show you a simple technique, and I did this on a Instagram live as well. I was a featured guest on her name is Pastor Loretta, but if you go to my Ciki Beauty page, I believe you will see it on my Instagram, like my Ciki Beauty Instagram, Ciki_beauty, and just look through my feed and you'll see it where I announced it. But we already did it, but I think it's on her IGTV. So anyway, I talked about keeping your brows all the way right. And we're going to get this face all the way right, too. And I got some new hair. Oh, I can't wait. But anyway, take your spoolie and brush your brow, or take a brush or whatever it is that you use for your brows. I kind of like to use a spoolie, right? So take it. And then what I do after that is I use my brow gel. Now, really, the next step, I actually pluck first, but that's because I am so used to cleaning my brows. For those of you guys that are not used to cleaning your brows via plucking, you may want to, I'm going to tweak my steps just for you, because I usually pluck, then I draw and proceed to do my brows per the use, right? But for you guys that may need a little bit of assistance that are not used to doing this, I'm going to draw them first. And the reason I'm going to draw them first is because you want to make sure that you're not over plucking. And sometimes when I do go to the nail salon to get my brows done, I will go with my eyebrows drawn on, because I want to give them, you know, an outline to follow, because I don't need them making me look like, like I'm walking around talking about, right? We don't need them like that. I want them to look how I want them to look. I am using my I love this stuff. This is the Ofra Semi-Permanent Eyebrow Gel, and it is in dark brown. And there you go. This is their new packaging. I always talk about this because this is really all I use, unless I'm just doing light brows, you know, and I'm not going anywhere, not doing any makeup or anything like that. Then I would use the Makeup Forever pencil, but you have to sharpen it to get this, to get like precision, like I like to get, right? Or you can always use a retractable pencil, like NYX has some, Anastasia Beverly Hills has some, Benefit has some. There are quite a few of them, but this one I use in number 40, and as you can see, she's well loved. What I'm gonna do is I actually put the brow gel on a palette right there. I put mine on a palette. I use this It Cosmetics brow pencil. I've had this for a while. I am simply gonna draw this on, and you want to use a angled brush. I prefer angled brush, but you gotta use what works for you, okay? But I do prefer an angled brush, and I do prefer an angled brush that is somewhat stiff, because I don't want it like, you know, being too soft and moving all over the place. I need it to be firm, and I need it to go where I tell it to go and nowhere else, okay? So what I do is, and I gotta tell y'all this, because I literally like place my brush in there, and then I kind of dab it around like that to get the excess off of it, because I don't need a whole bunch, right? I don't want to be walking around looking like I did my brows with a Sharpie. Just saying. So what I do is I then just begin to draw how I want my brows to look, right? And we know we embellish a little bit, baby, because I don't really have the arches that you about to see. So I just make that arch go a little higher. And then I connect everything. There she is. Ay, she coming to life. Ay, there she is. Ay, she looking good, baby. Ay, I don't know. And then I just kind of draw the rest of this and fill it in. But the part I want you guys to focus on the most is, first of all, drawing this. Not so much my shape. Uh-oh. Baby, I may have to clean up on aisle 7 a little bit, and that's okay. And then I'll show you guys the final look, but I'm only going to do the brows on camera because I don't want this to be super long. And then I, like, bring that out too. So I'm going to bring my magnifying mirror here, and I hope that y'all can see this like that. Yeah, that should be good. And then I take my magnifying mirror because it like zooms in 3 or 5 times. And then I just take these tweezers. I have some stainless steel tweezers that I love. And then I just go in right under where I've drawn. Now, usually I don't draw it on first because I do this a lot. And so I know, you know, where to pluck. But I'm showing you guys on a way that you can help, you know, not mess up. You could just follow your outline. This will look clean because, listen, I've seen some people out there looking like Harry and the Hendersons. And that is, I just don't think that, you know, I don't want that for your life. I don't want you looking like Harry and the Hendersons out there. Clean up, everybody everywhere. Clean up, clean up. So that's some good plucking. Yeah. I'm only going to do one brow and then I'm going to show you the final look. So now that I've done that, I simply go in like I would with my LA Girl, it is Pro Conceal. LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Fawn. And this is how I do it. And then I put a little bit on a palette, a little paper towel, whatever I need to do. This is just me. This is just the way I do it. I don't like to squeeze it out on here and do it that way because sometimes I put too much on there and I don't want to do that. So I just put a little bit on my paper towel and then I follow. I'm going to need my mirror again. Told you guys, these type of videos are a little bit harder because I want to be in focus and I need to be, even with contacts, I need to be close. Get closer to you, baby. And so I draw that in because we want it to be clean. So that is what I do there. And then I take a brush. Now this next brush that I'm gonna use is actually, and no judging, because yes, I did use this yesterday. But this is my MAC brush and I think it's the 212 brush. It is flat. It's kind of like the color of my skin, right? Because the concealer. But it's the 212, I believe. And let me get my other concealer. This right here, I take this brush, it's flat. So I like the fact that it's flat because it allows me to just kind of brush right under there and bring it down and bring it down. Then I just kind of go over that and I scoped it up there. Now you don't always have to do this, but if it's been a while since you got them things done, you do want to do this part. Sometimes when I do people's makeup, I don't have to scope the top. I just scope underneath and usually that's okay. For the sake of this video and the fact that I'm about to beat my face because we put on makeup and everything, I am doing it like I usually do. Now we're looking all good, girl. You see her? You see her? Now, usually I don't do this part till after I do both of them, but I'm going to do it now and just pray that that they look like at least sisters, not cousins. And so then I go under here. And for this one, I don't know, y'all, this is just my own little technique. So the other concealer I actually put on my hand because this is the same concealer, which is the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. This is in Chestnut. This one I actually use for my lid as well. So that's why I kind of put it on my arm. And then lately, because I ran out of corrector, I've been mixing that with my corrector. So I just put it on my hand. Like, my hand is a good palette as well. So then I forgot to tell you this brush. This is an angled brush that I use for my concealer, right? It's similar to the MAC one, but I think this is a Morphe. Yeah, it's a Morphe M165. And literally, these are the brushes. The brushes. These are the ones that I use every time because they have me blowing my mind. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. The last trick that I do, which I told you I'm only going to do this one on camera, but the last thing that I do is I take my finger and I blend that around like that. And then I take my other finger, my ring finger, and I just blend right here because I don't like that harsh square. So this is what makes my brows look super natural. Boom. And that's where we are, right? And so then to finish off the eye, I just take that concealer, that Too Faced concealer, the multi-sculpting one, wipe off this excess oil, and then I place the concealer all around my lid. So you can literally do this, pop on some lashes, and then just go about your day. And I recommend, you know, keeping your brows looking good, because your brows are what frames your face. Have you ever seen a picture where people look bomb, lipstick on, got a little complexion stuff on their face, and then the brows is like Harry and the Hendersons, and you're like, oh my gosh, that's cute. Oh, right? So I'm trying to get you all the way together. Fire fall on me. Like, I'm really fiery red. This is something new. Maybe I'll put the link in the description box, because baby, this is my first time rocking her and she is all the way cute. I will tell you what I added to the brows to match my red hair, even though it's dark up there in the roots. I added this Strut, Strut Brow Pencil by MAC. I do not know if it's still available, but even though it looks kind of brown, it does have a red tint to it. So whenever I rock red hair, I just kind of like go over my brows with a little bit of that, and it just gets me right. But I'm almost out, so I'm gonna need to check and see if they have more. There's no reason for y'all not to be feeling yourself on this quarantine. Get you a unit, baby. Pluck that. My daughter did it. Mini Me did it. Pluck that situation right there. Have that part looking real like, you know what I mean? And I do know that this is her. Oh, she's called Gabby. That's what she looks like, and she comes in different colors. And I'm definitely gonna go get some more, because I have a special thing coming up, which I'll share with y'all later. All right, so that is it for this video, you guys. If this video helped you, please comment below, please share, please thumbs up, because all of the above helps the channel, or all of the aforementioned, it helps the channel so much. And also, the other thing I wanted to ask you guys is, what else are you struggling with on this quarantine? Because I want to talk about it. Like, I am totally rocking press-ons, and I have been rocking press-ons ever since the whole quarantine situation. But that is it, y'all. You guys have an awesome, blessed day, and I will see you sooner than you think. And do not forget to join the fam bam. Mwah! Deuces.
Confidence is key. You know what I mean. A woman feels good when she's looking pretty. Yeah.